In this digital era of 21st century, where each and every device is using digital data for processing stuff and giving some output, processing digital data is easy and provides a good amount of privacy for any user. Now, we are still using the analog signals in day-to-day life. Why? Why these signals are important to us? If we have more efficient digital signals. In this video, I'll be talking about all these things and the methods like how you can convert digital to analog signals. In our environment, all the things which we see, hear, or feel are analog signals. Yes, this is true. We can't deny this fact. The sound from our headphones or a speaker, which we hear in our daily life, transmitting analog signals. The screen which we see of devices, such as smartphones, laptops, or even a TV, transmit analog signals. This is because we humans can only interpret analog signals. This is our limitation, and thus we have to convert digital information to analog signal. Bandwidth is one of the biggest factor when it comes to transmission of data between devices. It is the most expensive thing in transmitting data. Moreover, we have digital signals which use near to infinite bandwidth in order to get transmitted. On the other side, we have analog signals which use far more less bandwidth compared to the digital ones. Hence, we have to convert digital to analog so that we can transmit more amount of data in a given amount of bandwidth. Now that we get to know as to why conversion is required from digital to analog, let's dig in and get the info about how we can do these conversions. Now, as we know, sine wave have three components: amplitude, frequency, and phase. We can use these components by manipulating them according to a 0 or a 1 of a digital signal and convert it to analog signal. There are three types mainly based on these three components. These are amplitude shift keying, that is ASK, frequency shift keying, that is FSK, phase shift keying, that is PSK.
Amplitude shift keying. In amplitude shift keying, as we discussed earlier, and as the name suggests, we will manipulate sine wave's amplitude according to the bitstream of digital signal. Like this, we can represent it mathematically. Now to do this, we have a multiplier and an oscillator. The oscillator will generate a sine wave with some frequency, and it will be fed in the multiplier. Multiplier will multiply the incoming square wave or digital wave with the sine wave generated by the oscillator. Resulting wave will be analog, representing digital data in form of amplitude. To demonstrate this, I'm using Octave, an open source application. Here's the MATLAB code. frequency shift keying. In frequency shift keying, frequency will be manipulated according to the bitstream of digital signal. Like this, we can represent it mathematically. To do this, we will use voltage controlled oscillator. This voltage controlled oscillator uses the digital signal as its voltage and changes the frequency of sine wave accordingly. As the digital signal varies, the frequency of sine wave will change. Resulting wave will be analog, representing digital data in form of frequency. To demonstrate this, we will again head towards our beloved Octave. Here's the MATLAB code. Phase shift keying. In phase shift keying, phase will be manipulated according to the bitstream of digital signal. Like this, we can represent it mathematically. To do this, we will again use the multiplier and an oscillator combination. This time, the wave doesn't have a zero voltage level, it has a negative voltage level instead. Now, the same process like ASK will occur. The oscillator will generate a sine wave and feed it in multiplier. The square wave will be multiplied by sine wave. Resulting wave will be analog, representing data in form of phase. Now opening Octave and let's have a look on the MATLAB code.